From WPDE News Channel 15, your political news leader, continuing coverage of Vote 2006. Tonight, a debate between the candidates for state treasurer, Democrat Grady Patterson, and his Republican challenger, Thomas Ravenel. Meet the candidates who want to invest our state's money. Now, live from our WPDE studios, our moderator, Jim Heath.
Hi, everybody. Good evening. Welcome to the first of four televised debates that we'll be sponsoring here on WPDE prior to Election Day on November 7th. Tonight, we're joined by the Republican nominee for State Treasurer Thomas Ravenel. We are not joined by his Democratic challenger, incumbent Grady Patterson. We'll have more on that in just a minute. But, Mr. Ravenel, good to see you.
Good to see you, Jim.
Why don't we take just a minute to introduce yourself to our viewers tonight.
Okay, great. My name is Thomas Ravenel, and first of all, I want to thank Jim, you and the people here at WPDE-TV for allowing this forum. Also to thank the folks at home that are watching tonight because you cared enough about the important issues confronting South Carolina to tune in tonight. And I hope that through the way I answer my questions that I will earn your vote. And I'm just much appreciative that you're tuning in.
All right. For the political intrigue, let's go back to September 1st. Here's an actual press release that Grady Patterson, the incumbent, put out on September 1st. And he said, and I want to quote here, "Until Thomas is serious about being state treasurer, I will not be a part in his bid for the U.S. Senate. My opponent needs to stand before the public and state that he will serve 4 years and not challenge Senator Lindsey Graham for the U.S. Senate." Mm-hmm. That was back on September 1st. So let me ask you first, Mr. Ravenel, are you going to challenge Lindsey Graham for the U.S. Senate seat in 2008?
No, I've said it here. I'm saying it right now, and I've said it a number of times to a number of different folks. Absolutely. I have no intentions. I realize the complexity of this job and how important it is for someone to commit to 4 years, and I'm doing that.
Well, and as you mentioned, you have previously stated that you indeed you met that challenge, that you're not going to run against Lindsey Graham.
Right.
Then Mr. Patterson released a statement saying, well, now that you've said that, he's changed his mind and he is not going to debate you under any circumstance. So let me just ask you matter-of-factly, why do you think that is, that he will not debate you?
Quite frankly, I don't know, Jim. You know, a lot of people raise the age question, and I don't know, because he's not here with us to talk about these very important issues, because he's not here debating and defending his record. Who knows?
Let's take it a step further. He's been in office now as state treasurer since about the time you were born, the mid-1960s.
Well, I was four.
Okay, all right, since you were four.
Yeah.
That's right, he took office in 1966. Regardless, putting aside the age issue, there's an argument to be made that if he and his staff are doing a pretty good job managing the state's money, then maybe they should continue on. If indeed staff and Mr. Patterson are doing a good job, why do you specifically want to replace him and want the office?
Well, again, even if it's his staff, they're doing a very poor job. I mean, just take a look at our investments. In the last 3 years, if we had just achieved mediocrity, we would have $5 billion more in the retirement system. Take a look at the fact that he opposes tax cuts, prosperity-producing tax cuts. He opposes restructuring. He opposes doing the things our state needs to do to get out of last place. And we don't have a separation of powers. He opposes having this post being appointed. So there's so many things that we differ on, and whether it's him or a staff, is the bad, wrong policy. It's a status quo, and I'm against the status quo and special interest politics, and that's not what drives me. And I absolutely think after four decades, we need a change. Even if, go back to the 60s, you know, his leadership then was wrong for the state. In the 60s, most states were inequities. In 1999, we finally got inequities. We're the last state in the union to get inequities. And to this day, we're the only state in the union that does not invest globally. So I just think he's behind the times. He's not intellectually curious enough to see what the other states are doing. He's not advancing policies that would make the state grow its economy so that we can be more prosperous and competitive.
Let me put a period on this portion and just state for our viewers once again that Mr. Patterson was invited to participate tonight quite some time ago. We've got a chair off to the side here. He's welcome during the next 30 minutes at any point to join us and be part of this discussion. But with that said, let's move on.
Surely.